They may not look like much at first glance, but our parks are home to a dazzling array of wildlife, mini ecosystems that rely on the survival of every animal inside that park to make it a space we can all enjoy.
Hi, I'm Dr. Anna Hart, and I'm here to show your world of nature on your doorstep. Welcome to Park Life.
Today, we're visiting the Gunnersbury Triangle Nature Reserve. We'll see some frogs, we'll see some interesting fungi, and we'll learn about how you can become a Park Life Ranger and help us save this space. Round the back of Chiswick Park Station is a small nature reserve. The Gunnersbury Triangle.
I'm here today to find one of my favourite animals, the common European frog. The common frog is found all over Europe, as far north as the Arctic Circle and as far east as Japan. They arrive here in spring once the temperature is consistently over 10 degrees and try and find any body of still water in which to breed. Let's try and find some frogs.
Here at Gunnersbury Triangle, they've created a haven for all amphibious life, and I think we've got a really good chance of seeing some of our little friends.
This spot is a great place for frogs because of the plant coverage. It provides protection for the frog spawn, as well as a hiding spot for the small frogs. The size of it is also fantastic because it means there won't be any territorial disputes between the frogs, newts and toads that all share this space.
Frogs can lay up to 4,000 eggs a night, and they do so just under the surface of the water and between the reeds. To protect them, their eggs taste disgusting to predators. Frogs come out in spring when the temperature is consistently above 10 degrees. It's been pretty warm recently, so these tadpoles have hatched a little earlier than expected.
Frogs here will hunt flying insects, as well as worms, slugs and snails. Frogs aren't fussy eaters. The frogs themselves are also a tasty treat, with otters, herons and even the occasional house cat hunting our amphibious friends.
Have you got a frog in your pond? Have you seen any mushrooms? Send us a pic and we'll feature it on our socials. Find us on Insta, TikTok and Twitter.
Thanks to a group of organised locals, this park was saved from development in the 1980s and again in 2012. It is run by the London Wildlife Trust.
It now boasts an environment teeming with life.
Locals say that they love this park for its calm and quiet. It's a special place where you can get away from the busy rush of Chiswick High Street. You can check their website for open days and join in on their famous fungi trail.
Even though the Gunnersbury Triangle is a site of metropolitan importance for nature conservation, it is always under threat from development.
Want to be a Park Life Ranger? Send us a video of you in your favourite park and tell us why you love it.
This is a really great example of some of the wildlife that you can find at the Gunnersbury Triangle. It's a common species of mushroom known as the turkey tail. And the reason it's called the turkey tail is if I turn it over here, you can see on the top it has these beautiful colourful rings like the tail of a turkey. Now its Latin name is Tramites versicolor. Versicolor means many colours, and that's because in different countries it becomes different colours. Another interesting thing is if I turn it upside down, you can see this amazing structure on the underside. If I touch it, it looks like it should be quite rough, but it's actually pretty smooth. Now, something to remember if you ever touch something when you're outside is to wash your hands as soon as you can. I'm going to put this back so other wildlife can enjoy it.
Even though the Gunnersbury Triangle is a site of metropolitan importance for nature conservation, it is always under threat from development.
Ongoing major developments at Chiswick Business Park, two big residential sites, and floodlights on surrounding plots are interfering with the wildlife here. Recently, a 9-storey block of flats has been slated to be developed here. The noise pollution alone from construction is likely to drive the animals away from this area into more suitable space. However, there is nowhere suitable nearby. Without the animals, the ecosystem will collapse. If you care about natural spaces in urban environments, contact us online. The animals deserve to live here just as much as we do.
Want to be a park life ranger? Want us to feature your park? Get in touch. You can reach out to us on social media or via our website. We'd love to hear from you.
If you have a garden, you can check out the Wildlife Trust website on how to build a pond that's perfect for our froggy friends.
Today, we caught some tadpoles of the common European frog. We learned about the turkey tail, a magic colour-changing mushroom. And we learned how you can get involved and help save your green spaces by becoming a Park Life Ranger. I'm Dr. Anna Hart, and thanks for watching Park Life.